G'day there, everyone. Welcome to the very first episode of Q&A with Dr. Zen, aka Derek Moran. After a long period of absence from YouTube, I have decided to reboot Movie Studio Zen one last time on YouTube. To achieve a successful reboot of this channel, I have come up with some new ideas, which I hope you will all like, to make Movie Studio Zen more interesting to watch and interact with. The first new thing will be a weekly Q&A session where you get to ask me anything you like. Now, if you have a question or problem about how to do something in Vegas Pro, Vegas Movie Studio, DVD Architect, how to paint your cat, that sort of thing, you can post your questions underneath this video here or also on the Movie Studio Zen Facebook page. I'll also be including interesting questions I find that have been posted under my other YouTube videos during the previous week. Even though I haven't been regularly uploading new tutorials for a long time, I have never stopped answering everyone's questions. So I thought it was time to start sharing the knowledge with everyone and not just a select few. Late last year, I did a few surveys and I asked people which video editing program they mainly use today. The results were basically split into three camps. 50% of you are using Vegas Movie Studio, 50% are using Vegas Pro, and everybody else has left the building. The main reason I asked this question was to work out what type of tutorials I should be making. Now, because the results were split 50-50, I will aim to upload two new tutorials each week, one for Vegas Movie Studio users and one for Vegas Pro users. I also realised that if I want Movie Studio Zen to grow as a channel, I need to upload new videos on a regular weekly schedule. I know from my YouTube analytics that more of you seem to be watching my videos on the weekend and during the week. So to start this new schedule, I will aim to upload new tutorials each Saturday or Sunday and do the weekly Q&A in the middle of the week. Okay, let's move on to some general news. So it's been almost 3 years since a new version of Vegas Movie Studio was released. Magic Software now owns Vegas Movie Studio and they will be releasing three new versions before the end of February 2017. The new versions will be called Vegas Movie Studio 14, Vegas Movie Studio 14 Platinum, and Vegas Movie Studio 14 Suite. Some of the new features that have been added to Vegas Pro will also be added to Vegas Movie Studio. If you would like to learn a little more about the coming release of Vegas Movie Studio 14, you can read a short interview with Gary Repholz on the Vegas Magazine website. And I think I put a link there. So Gary is the captain of the new Vegas development team, and he was also with Sony Software for many, many years. He has been actively listening to everyone's complaints and suggestions about Vegas, and I believe he is very sincere in wanting to see Vegas Movie Studio succeed and move in a positive direction. One thing that should give us great hope about the new version is the news that Vegas Movie Studio 14 will have a new modern user interface that makes working with the software over long periods of time much easier on the eyes and the brain while giving the user a more realistic view of critical color content. That's a little quote from Gary. Now, one last thing before I finish today. Starting next week, I will begin to answer some of the best questions from the last 7 days. Many of the questions I get asked each week are fairly easy to answer because they relate to common questions that have already been answered hundreds of times before. However, I also get asked questions which are not easy to answer with just words. These types of complex questions can only be answered by making an actual video tutorial. So here is one of those complex questions to get started. A few days ago, Walter asked, Hi Derek. You are my go-to source for info on video editing. I do a lot of drone video and have problems with exposure during low light angles. I'm running with polarizing and ND filters, However, the bright areas are still blown out while the shady areas are underexposed. Is there a solution I can use in post with Sony Vegas? Thanks, Walt. A short time after Walter posted this question, he then asked me a second question. I'm currently running Sony Platinum 13 and I'm considering upgrading to Pro 14. I've installed the trial version and frankly, I'm not impressed. It doesn't seem to offer much more than Platinum 13. Am I missing something? So ironically, both of those great questions are closely related to each other. So I will be uploading a new tutorial that answers both of these questions at the same time in a few days' time. The short answer to question one is that there is a solution for dealing with extremes in exposure. This is best achieved by using Vegas Pro because only Vegas Pro has the masking tool. This is one of the main tools I would normally use to help adjust problem areas that are too dark or too light. Because with the masking tool, you can cut out precise areas that need adjusting and then apply color correction tools just to that specific area. You can also do a similar technique in Vegas Movie Studio. However, because there is no masking tool in Vegas Movie Studio, you are limited to using just the cookie cutter tool to isolate problem areas of poor exposure. Vegas Pro also comes with video scopes, which are an invaluable tool for fixing exposure problems in video, whereas Vegas Movie Studio does not include scopes, so it makes it more difficult to do accurate color correction. So as you can see, it's not easy to answer these types of complex questions with just words. So stay tuned for a new video on this topic very soon, which I will upload in the next couple of days. Thanks for watching. See you all in next week's Q&A. Sorry this first video is a little bit boring, a little bit dry. Promise you, next week it'll be short and snappy and just strictly Q&A. See ya.